happened in an aluminium car 10 or 15 years ago, the accident damage to these guys in them would have been far worse. I mean, to see Rubens walking about this morning was as a delight, really, the level of the impact yesterday. But it just goes to show how good the survival cells in cars are now, and progressing all the time.
We will try and bring you news of...
A different view, looking further down the straight as the cars come out of the Tamburello corner, and everything appears to be totally normal as it comes down the straight, and we shall then probably cut on there. That's something, that was bodywork flying off the car. We just see it. Let's go back again. We can see that's more like, was that part of the wing, or is that just part of the side pod of the bodywork?
I reckon it's either the side pod or maybe the bodywork, the engine cover jump, but it looks very much like a side pod.
Certainly something has come off that car, and that is what has caused the incident to commence. Obviously, there we have a backward view, but well, that's the wing you can just see on the ground. That's probably the consequence of the initial first impact, and the car now just dissipating energy all the way down, right down to the apex of the Tosa Herpen bend.
20 minutes into the one-hour session, the very popular Austrian driver, Roland Ratzenberger, unaccountably went off the circuit at some 190 miles an hour, straight into a concrete barrier at the side of the track. His car disintegrated.
Ladies and gentlemen, the San Marino Grand Prix organizer has received a report from the Maggiore Hospital in Bologna that the driver of car number 32, MTV Simtek Ford, Roland Ratzenberger, succumbed to injuries sustained in the accident which took place at Imola Circuit during Saturday qualifying practice, April the 30th.